I did tell you that I would be reviewing a lot more electric vehicles as they come in. So last time I reviewed the eTron 55 SUV, which we quite loved. Now I'm in the rather more exciting GT model, which sits at the top of the eTron range, only trumped by the RS GT. So this could kind of be considered the baby GT, but I can tell you there's nothing baby about it.
It's really great to see more and more EVs arriving, even if they are of the premium type. At this time, we have EVs offered by BMW, Jaguar, Porsche, Volvo, and Mini. Mercedes-Benz is soon to join the party with its EQ lineup. But for now, let's focus on this flagship from the German brand. It is certainly a head-turner. I've only driven it a few days, but the amount of stares and conversations that have been had around the look of this car is crazy. It really stands out as something quite special.
Just like the eTron 55, this interior is very, very familiar Audi. So there's nothing particularly special about it or that shouts that this is an EV, which is a little bit disappointing, I have to say. But again, maybe Audi just wants to keep it all a little bit more familiar so that it's not so sort of jarring when, you know, you get into an electric vehicle. This is also the flagship model, so I would have liked it to feel just that extra bit special.
With that said, it comes with a lot of luxury and comfort features, but be aware, you'll be paying for most of them. In fact, this test model has ventilated seats with a massage function that will set you back around 15,000 Rand. Not to mention the 78,000 Rand you'll pay for these sport seats pro up front. Even adaptive cruise control will cost you a whopping 33,000 Rand. On a car that is already around the 2.7 million Rand mark, I find this a little cheeky. With all the extra options on this test car, the final price comes in just over 3 million Rand. Hell's bells.
With that said, this is no baby. Okay, you're getting 350 kilowatts of power and 630 newton meters of torque. Now, if you want to get to 100 kilometers power in just 4.1 seconds, you activate launch control, and for 2.5 seconds, you will have 390 kilowatts of power and 640 newton meters. Like I said, it's no baby. Now the RS GT will get you there in 3.3 seconds or something. Okay, but that's like really quick. But either way, it has that very, very addictive instant power that when you put your foot down, your head goes back, you can feel like the G-forces. A lot of people are sort of underwhelmed in the sense because there's no engine noise. Again, that doesn't bother me. I find it to be quite sort of addictive regardless, you know, just because I don't need the roar. But I understand why a lot of sort of petrol heads or even people who just like that V8, V6 are maybe missing it.
What's more important in EVs though is their range. The GT is claimed to have a range of between 433 and 472 kilometers. In terms of charging price, you're looking at around 230 Rand for a full charge if you're charging at home. Charge it at a mall or an external charger, for example, and depending on the price, which can go up to around 6 Rand per kilowatt hour, you can expect more along the lines of about 500 Rand. Still, it's cheaper than that if it were an internal combustion engine.
Like I said in the other EV review, I think it's going to be a while before South Africans adopt a really, truly EV life. And I think if I'm spending close to 3 million Rand on a car, I want all the creature comforts added already, and I want it to feel that extra bit special.
Then there's the hassle of keeping the charge up, which would maybe get a bit much for people. But that will just take some time getting used to. Either way, this is an uber comfortable and really special EV. I've thoroughly enjoyed driving it and I'm quite sad to see it go. I would quite happily have one of these in my garage, along with an ICE vehicle too, of course, which I would easily find on Gumtree.